Yeah, to close chapter 3, there is a last small chapter, 3.9. The theme of this is has nothing to do with temperature control and flash design. It has something to do with Bode plots. I want to show you a way to draw the Bode plot of a closed loop if the Bode plot of open loop is given. Given Bode plot of open loop. That's I think important if we don't know the transfer function. Note that the Bode plot is only the fingerprint of the transfer function. Transfer function of a system contains complete information. Bode plot is just a small part of information. Can I use the small part of information of the open loop to get the small part information of the closed loop that is behind this chapter? The answer is yes, it is possible. The way goes in the following steps. First, I draw the general signal block diagram of which we are talking about, negative feedback, and we have only one block. We called this FO the open loop transfer function or open loop system. Open loop contains all blocks. The controller contains the actuator, contains the process itself and contains the sensor. Yeah. C controller, A actuator. So all blocks in the loop without feedback. Actuator, P process and S sensor. So all parts of a loop are called open loop, and without this we have no feedback, but including feedback, then this is the closed loop system. And the closed loop system, the transfer function of the closed loop system can be calculated with the transfer function of the open loop system. So this is valid for all points of the open loop system, so also for the small part of the Bode plot. So for each point of the Bode plot, this is valid. Problem is, this is then a complex calculation. Yeah, if we have the Bode plot, note that the magnitude curve and the phase curve are parts of a complex number. So we can say also valid for sigma is 0, so we have the complex frequency response. So we can, of course, use the same equation with the complex frequency response. The open loop complex frequency response is this. Note that the complex frequency response is also a complex number. Is a magnitude times e to the power of j omega divided by 1 plus the magnitude of the frequency response a to the sorry, not e omega, that's quatsch, phi j phi open loop. So j phi open loop. So, if you have a point of a Bode plot, then you have the value of the magnitude, value of the magnitude and the value of the phase, and put these both values in this complex calculation, then you get the magnitude and phase of the closed loop system. So, point by point, you have just to execute this equation to get this. That is, there's two problems, of course. Sometimes We need only approximations, and I will show you in the first step approximation information. And secondly, not all people has a handheld calculator which can calculate these complex numbers. Of course, there are today there are calculators available who can easily convert this. But note that the values here are linear values, not dB values. So if you have dB values from a Bode plot, you have to convert into linear values, and here you get then the magnitude of the closed loop. Then you have, of course, convert this back into the decibel value. So this is time consuming, and sometimes I will give you the approximation is absolutely sufficient. So first, look for approximations. This is also helpful for understanding closed loop systems, because you get now information which helps in designing closed loop systems. I can make an approximation if I have a sum, and in this sum, one of this part of the sum is small compared with the other part. So we can say, okay, there are two ways of approximation. This is small compared with one, or this is large compared with one. So we make first, if the magnitude is large compared with one, then we can neglect the phase. If this is large, we can neglect the one. We can say, okay, in this case, the closed loop frequency response is, and note, if this is large, we can neglect the one. If this one is gone, then you see we have the numerator and denominator are identical. So we get our one, which is 0 dB in the Bode plot. That means, back to closed loop system, what happens if the closed loop system function is 1? Note, we have discussed this again. Then we can say the closed loop transfer function is a ratio of the controlled value divided by the desired value or reference value. If this is 1, 0 dB, then you see x is equal w. That means the controlled value is exactly the desired value. That is good control. In the opposite, what happens if we have small open loop gain? This is the open loop gain. Yeah? If we have small open loop gain compared with 1, then we can say, okay, in this case, then you can make the opposite approximation. If this is small compared with 1, or 1 is large against this, we can neglect this part, and just we have as a result closed loop and open loop have the same value. That means if the magnitude is small, we have no control, exactly no control. In this case, there is no change caused by the negative feedback. That is, this, as if we have no feedback, then we have an open loop system, and an open loop system has really not a big control over the output. Let's look into an example. Assume we have an open loop system, and the Bode plot is given. The Bode plot is normally drawn about versus the logarithmic value of omega, and this is then the magnitude in dB. Look what happens here. What we want is good control. What we have to do is large gains. So we can assume a good control system starts with large gain for low frequencies. If the Actuator and process and sensor have not large gain. Of course, the controller should have large gain because this can be influenced in our design of the controller. We need large gain to get large open loop gain. If you have large open loop gain, then we have good control. That is the first statement. So in normal typical systems, for low frequencies, we have large gain, but this, yeah, of course we would have this for all frequencies, but we know each sensor, each actuator, each process has mainly low pass characteristic caused by mechanics, caused by capacitors and so on. So typical process functions are low pass functions. So we know this goes down at some frequencies. So we normally have this open loop magnitude curve of my system. Note here, this frequency is very important. We call this omega d, that is the crossover frequency. Omega d is the crossover frequency. Then we can say, okay, for low frequencies, the first approximation is valid. For high frequencies, the second approximation is valid. So we can at once try to draw the closed loop magnitude curve in the following way. We can say, okay, in this case, large gain, we see that the closed loop Bode plot is 0 dB. So this is valid as long as the magnitude is large or labels large distance over the 0 dB line. Here in this region, this approximation is not valid. So we look for the second approximation. Where is this valid? If the magnitude curve is deep under the 0 dB line. So we can say, okay, this is the closed loop transfer function, FW of a magnitude in dB. But the problem is now here in this region, we don't know what happens. I will show you what could be. It could be that we have this curve. It could also be that we have this curve. And this, what happens here, can only be calculated if you go directly in the correct calculation. And I tell you this behavior, what happens here in the crossover frequency range, it depends on the phase. Yeah, depends on phase values in the near of omega d. That is a point we will deeply discuss in chapter 5. If we look for the Bode plot design of closed loop systems. What we can just consider is in green color, I want to show you a good estimation when, yeah, we want to know, is there a good thumb rule? Can I say thumb? Thumb rule means good idea that we can say, okay, this distance is far enough to draw a 0 dB line. And here, where is the region where the approximation is not valid? I show you a good estimation. Assume that we have here a distance of 20 dB or larger, 20 dB or larger. Yeah. The same is here, if we have here 20 dB or larger. If this distance is larger than 20 dB, what does that mean? That does mean 20 dB is a factor of 10, that this magnitude value, independent of phase value, this magnitude value is in the region of 10 or larger. And if I neglect the 1 compared with the 10, then I make an error of 10%. If f open loop larger than 20 dB, error less than 10%. And now remember the table with the dB values. 1 dB change is around 12% error. So we can say 0 dB is 1 dB is 1.12, so this is 12% larger than 1. So a change of 1 dB is a change in linear of 12%. We can say if we are larger than more than 20 dB over the 0 dB line, then the accuracy of the closed loop system, accuracy of my approximation here, is less than 1 dB. So if open loop magnitude is larger than 20 dB, error is smaller than 10%, or error of closed loop magnitude is smaller than 1 dB. So this is a good estimation. So we can say, okay, if we are deeper than 20 dB, the same is true. If this is 0.1 and this is 1, we neglect the 0.1 factor, then the error is also in the region of 10%, and the change here will be less than 1 dB. So if we are deeper than negative 20 dB, then the accuracy of my approximation is less than 1 dB, and note in typical border plot designs, 1 dB is 1 millimeter. Yeah, 1 dB typical, 1 dB is round about 1 millimeter in our drawing. That's a normal typical scaling. So we can say, okay, in general, we can say, okay, the feedback shifts or cuts the part which looks over the 0 dB line of the open loop, cuts it down to the 0 dB line. That is the influence of the negative feedback, just cutting this down to this line. Here the negative feedback has no influence. So what we have to do in our closed loop design is make this possible higher than 20 dB as long for high frequencies. The higher this omega d value, the faster you loop. If it is possible that you can shift all these parts up, then the closed loop effect for high frequencies will be better, and then your system reacts faster on changes and so on. Yeah, the goal is make omega d large, then your system becomes fast. Okay, but what happens now in the second step? The 3.9.1 exact calculation with real with real numbers. If you want to do this in C sharp or so on, then of course complex calculation is not so supported. I think some years ago also handheld calculators are not able to offer complex calculations. Today, of course, this is not a real problem. Of course, you can use your Casio also with complex calculation method. But if not, I show you just the Nichols equations. Nichols has converted this complex equation into two real equations. Use Nichols equations. You should know this is a question also 50 years ago the scientists work on. And of course then this was impossible to calculate with handheld calculators. And they have no handheld calculator, so they use diagrams. So I learned control system with so-called Nichols diagrams. So in a diagram, there are curves where you get points, where you just get points for the phase of the closed loop and the magnitude of the closed loop, depending on the magnitude and phase of the open loop. Rather uncomfortable today. We have Nichols equations, and you can find this in the workbook. Just have a quick look in the workbook, page 34. Let's have a quick look there. Yeah, here you see the discussion in the chapter 3.9, Nichols formulas, Nichols equations. Here, look for this approximation box. Yeah, if open loop is larger, smaller, minus 20 dB, no control. If larger, 20 dB, we have a control, 0 dB, good control effect. And here you can see the Nichols equation. This is the closed loop magnitude, closed loop phase, open loop magnitude, not in dB, but in factor, and open loop phase. And these both equations can be derived from the complex equation with some intermediate steps. So I think I just make a copy for my writing for these equations. Now, these are the copies. Note that this is the closed loop magnitude and the closed loop phase. I have an additional index, a W here in this line. This is the open loop note, F magnitude values not in dB. So if you read a value from Bodeplot, convert into a factor, calculate this equation, get a factor, and reconvert in dB values. This chapter 3.9, we want to execute now with an example. So that we can check what happens and additionally understand the behavior of a closed loop Bode plot. Yeah, that will come in the next video. This video is number 40.